Subok ang pasensya ko. Tapos, wala pang extra bayan. Bastos talaga. I am an au pair and I am proud that I am able to be part of the program. I don't care if they categorize my work as a house helper, babysitter, whatever. It is a noble work and I earn good money. And also, this program has been a huge help to improve myself and my family. Anyway, it is my third country now participating in a au pair program. And I live with 5 different host families so I can compare who's nicer or not based on how they treated me as their au pair. I don't know what au pair means was when I first came to Denmark. I just signed a contract without signing what was it all about. So when the host family asked me to do this and that, even though it's not a contract, I always said yes, because I'm scared to say no, since it is my first time and inexperienced. So I changed host families 3 times in Denmark, because we're not a match at all. Nagpa-piano kasi yung babae right after I cleaned. Hindi literal na piano ha, gano'n. It's a term used sa mga kasambahay. So if you have been an all-around helper, then you can relate how it feels to see your host family doing this in front of you. Because she doesn't want to see any fingerprints or dust inside the house. Sobrang meticuloso niya when it comes to cleaning. It has to be shining, shimmering, and splendid. Kahit sa ilalim ng bed, sa sink, sofa, table, pinapiano niya. Kapag naliligo ako everyday, I'm living in luxury daw. Nakakaya ang confession na to. Doon ko natutunan na maligo once or twice a week. Anyway, no food allowed inside my room. Yung trash can ko, for papers only. Every time na nagtatapon ako sa basurahan nila, chine-check niya. Military time. Kailangang 6 a.m. sharp, ando na ako. 1 minute late is a big deal. Papagalitan ako, as in, sisinghalan ako. And doon ko natutunan din kung paano lunukin ang luha bago tutulog. Kibay to! From 6 a.m. to 9 p.m, straight duty yon until sometimes around 2 a.m. babysitting. Kapag nag-night out sila, at least twice a week, tapos wala pang extra bayan. May dalawa silang aso. Maba summer, spring, autumn, winter, kailangan ilabas 4 to 6 times a day. Pag naiwan naman ang lunchbox ng mga anak niya, magbabike ako ng 16 kilometer back and forth na yon. Kasi nga, I'm stupid! Stupid ako, stupid! Everyday, pinapahanginan ko lahat ng kumot at unan nila, kahit mag-snowstorm pa. Every meal, I need to prepare everyone's medicines and vitamins. After meal, as expected, I had to do the dishes on my own. There's a special occasion like birthday, Christmas, family gathering. As expected, ako yung tagahugas manually using hot water. Not lukewarm, but hot water. Lalo na yun sa mga white glass na kailangan walang bakas na makikita. Kasi kapag meron, ipapaulit sa akin at wala akong thank you na maririnig sa kanila. Bastos talaga. Yung day off ko naman, every Wednesday. Kaya it's hard to find group of people na makasalwa ko kasi normal day off na mga au pairs, Saturday and Sunday. Kaya...
Lonely, I'm still lonely.
General cleaning, laundry, cooking, babysitting, magpala sa snow, gardening, window cleaning, magwalis sa parking area nila na doon talaga sinusubok ang pasensya ko. Alam na kapag utom, yung dahon na hindi matapos-tapos, kakahulog, lahat ng mga gawain na ano pair should not do, ginagawa ko. Masakit man wala, pinapatrabaho ako. But never did I complain because I'm not ready to go home. Though I exert 101% of my effort, still not good enough for them, and I will never be enough in their eyes no matter what. Lazy is what they always say to me. I was an au pair in Denmark but feels like I'm not because of my bad experience, and that brought me to a realization that life is all about decision making. I knew that it is going to happen, but I let myself unguarded be taken for granted, and that is the main reason why my host family became so abusive. I could avoid it if I wanted to, but I let the fear controlled me, afraid for myself, for my future, and for my family. And many times my host mom threatens me to send back to the Philippines, and she knew that I am not ready to go home yet. So she used that as a weapon to scare me, to put fear in my heart, and made me obey her, using my weakness to use me. And I was 20 years old that time, and what would you expect of a 20 years old living with a foreign family alone, and the only priority is to help her family support financially? And who would want to go back home without saving and have just started working? Of course, kapit ako sa patalim since napasakamay ko ng opportunity na hinahangad ng iba. Tipitawan ko pa ba? But after 1 year of hard work, sacrifice, and maltreatment, I left the family unnoticed because I realized that it's not a good environment to me anymore. And I need not to expose more of myself to emotional abuse. And I know that there is a family out there that will treat me nicer. That family taught me a lot of lessons in life, and if not because of them, I would probably not grow and mature as a person. Though they did not treat me the way it should be, still I would be grateful that they came into my life, because that experience was a training for me to become a strong and courageous woman. The hardships I experienced in their hands have a huge contribution to who I am today. To mention discipline, responsibility, maturity, expectations, patience, hard work, self-worth, humbleness, open-minded, and also save money. Of course, I cried a lot, I sweat a lot, I work a lot for 1 month to earn that money, so I cannot spend it for no reason. However, in spite of the bad experience, I assessed it positively that it's all for my sake, to remain strongly optimistic in life no matter how hard life is. I will not give up, I will keep reaching my dreams, and I will put my heart into what I am doing. I am sure some of yours can relate, so if you're one of those, please drop down your experience at the comment section below. Describe your worst au pair experience in one word. Thanks for watching. And please consider to click the subscribe button below. Bye bye.